गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप मल्टीप्लिकेशन इन डेसिमल्स मस्ट बी क्लियर टू यू। आई हैव सीन यू पीपल हैव डन द वर्क्स नाइसली एंड आई एम रिक्वेस्टिंग द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर नॉट सबमिटिंग देयर वर्क्स, काइंडली डू योर वर्क्स ऑन टाइम। लेट अस बिगिन आवर टुडेज लेक्चर दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट डिवीजन ऑफ डेसिमल्स। बाय नाउ यू नो हाउ टू ऐड, हाउ टू सब्ट्रैक्ट, हाउ टू मल्टीप्लाई। सो द लास्ट ऑपरेशन लेफ्ट इज division of decimals. Now how to begin everything I'll be explaining you with an example. Please look here. First topic will be division of decimal by 10, 100, 1000, 10,000. Everywhere the concepts will be same. Let us consider one example. 27.5 divided by 10. So this part is a decimal, remember? And we have studied in earlier classes how to convert a decimal part to a fraction part and how to change a fraction to a decimal. So here what we will do, 27.5 we will be writing in the fractional form. So how to write in fraction form? First we will write 275 and in the new denominator we will write 1. Now you will see the number, it has one digit after decimal, so I will put 10. So 27.5 will be 275 by 10. I think this is clear. We have already done this. Fine. So now the question will be changed to 275 by 10 divided by 10 it was given. So you know that any number can be written in a fractional form as 10 by 1. Now this division part will be changed to multiplication part. Remember, division we have done in fractions. Division of fractions, same concept. So 275 by 10 into division will be changed to into, and the next fraction will be reciprocated, inverted. So 10 by 1 will become 1 by 10. Now 275 into 1 is 275, 10 into 10 is 100. So now our new answer is 275 by 100. In decimals it will be how many digits? 1, 2. So from the back, 1, 2. The decimal will come here, so the answer will be 2.75. If you see what happened actually, the decimal shifted one position to the left hand side. See one question I am taking of your exercise 3.3, page 46. Question number 1, subpart 5 is saying 3.79 divided by 100. Now I am not writing everything, I am not explaining you. 3.79 in fractions will be, first you will write 379 by 1. Now here how many digits after decimal? 2 digits after decimal. So 1 will have 2 digit, 2 zeros. So the number will be 379 by 100 divided by 100 by 1. Again 379 by 100, changing your division sign to multiplication sign and reciprocating the next fraction by 1 by 100. So it will be 379 by 10,000. So 10,000 means from the back how many zeros are here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4 is not here. So I will add a zero here and then I will put the decimal. Because 4 zeros now. So, 4 digits should come before putting the decimal. So, the answer is 0.0379. This is clear? Now, we will start division of decimal by whole number. See, here actually directly also you can do. But I want to teach you the basic concept. Rather than learning how the decimal is shifting to right or left, please follow the pattern, nothing will happen. One more question is there, second part, 2.5 divided by 100. Now 2.5 means 10, since I have 1 digit after decimal, so 25 by 10 divided by 100 by 1. Then this is actually a fraction part, so division of fraction we have done, 25 by 10 into 1 by 100 is 25 by 1000. Now 3 zeros, we have only 2 digits, so adding a 0, 1, 2, 3. And a 0 point. Why we are adding a 0? Because here 3 zeros are there after 1. So it means 1, 2 and 3 digits should come before placing the decimal. Now we will see division of decimal by a whole number. Whole number can be apart from your 10, 100 and 1000, it can be any number. Just see one example. Divide 16.56 by 3. We will follow the same rules of division as we have studied earlier. So 3 and 16.56, as you know how to write. So how many times it will go? 3 5s are 15. Subtracting 15, what is left is 1. Now, if you see here, the decimal is there. I don't want the decimal. So, I will put the decimal in the quotient area. Fine. As soon as I put the decimal, I can copy the next number. That is 5. So, again, 3 5s are 15. What is left is 0, 0. Copying the next number, that is 6. 3 2s are 6. What is left is 0. And how to check? Hope you remember the division algorithm. Dividend is equal to quotient into divisor. When you will multiply these two numbers, you will get this answer. So I have done to show you 5.52 into 3 will be 16.56. So check, my answer is correct. So the answer is 5.52. That is the way of checking, just to see whether your answer is correct or not. Now I am taking question number 2, subpart 2nd. Divide 20.4 by 6. Same thing we will do. 6, 20.4. So now how many times? 6, 3s are 18. 20 minus 18 is a 2. Now decimal is there. What I will do? I will shift the decimal in the quotient area. Decimal will come in the quotient area. As soon as I shifted my decimal, I will copy the next number, that is 4. So my new number is 24. So 6 4s are 24. Remainder is 0. Now how to check? Multiply your quotient and divisor. So 3.4 into 6 is 20.4. So yes, my answer is correct. I am only teaching you two ways of division in decimal here. Next two things we will study in the next class. So please try to recall them. Solve the examples given in your book, and I am only giving selected questions for you all to solve as homework, but you can do all the questions of the exercise for upgrading your skill. So today's homework is question number 1, 3rd and 6th part, question number 3, 1st and 3rd part. I hope you know which exercise we are talking about. We are talking about exercise 3.3, page 46. That's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.